Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So don't forget, I'm shooting these back to back, so the shirt's gonna be green for all of it. First, we're gonna talk about Batman from 1966. This is a continuation of the 66 TV show. I was gonna grab all the... Oh wait, I moved them over here. I don't have to. Did I put them in the right order? I did. It's just stuff's in the way. It's a continuation of this massive, starting here. Here's season one. This is all of season two right here. Season three. I'd have to say season two's the best. Season three is probably the worst. Kind of drags on. I'll put those away later. But, good show if you haven't seen it. So campy, so enjoyable. So, the movie is a continuation of sorts. It's directed by Leslie H. Martinson and narrated by William Dozier. From 1966, an action comedy starring Adam West as Bruce Wayne or Batman. Burt Ward is Dick Grayson and Robin. Burgess Meredith as Penguin. Cesar Romero as Joker. Lee Merriweather as Catwoman. Alan Napier as Alfred. Frank Gorshin as the Riddler. Stafford Rep as Chief O'Hara. And Neil Hamilton as Commissioner Gordon. Has a 78% on Rotten Tomatoes. I was very shocked by that. I kind of expected this to have a much lower score just because of how goofy it is, but no. And you know what? Gotta hand it to him. Off of a budget of $1.5 million, which was a lot back in the 60s, the film made $3.9 million at the box office and rentals. It says it made mostly out of rentals. But I just kind of said, you know what, we'll say box office, it'll be easier. So, as I said, this feels like an extended episode of the 60s Batman TV show, as it should. The United Underworld, which is made up of Riddler, Joker, Penguin, Catwoman, kidnap Commodore Schmidlap, who is played by Reginald Denny in his final role, as he died in 1967 from a stroke. He was born in 1891. So he's probably the, I don't want to say oldest, but, he has the oldest birth date, we'll say, for lack of a better phrase, than any other actor I've talked about so far, and probably ever will talk about. He started his career back in 1915 in a silent film called Niobe, where he played Cornelius Griffin. So, back to the plot. They kidnap him for his dehydrator invention to dehydrate this movie's version of the United Nations. Along the way, they use Catwoman, disguised as Miss Kitka, to lure Batman slash Bruce Wayne, it's just Bruce Wayne, but it's easier to say Batman, into a trap. Bruce falls for her, and when it's revealed it's Catwoman, he is devastated. You actually kind of feel the emotion, but I've also watched this movie since I was about 8, so. The final battle, it's more like a fist fight, takes place on Penguin's submarine that has paddles shaped like flippers. So instead of the turbines at the back of it, it's got little flipper paddles. My Switch is making noises. So, after the United Underworld succeeds in dehydrating the UN, it turns them into dust. They put the dust in little vials, and they take them with them on the boat. Batman and Robin must rehydrate the council after the dust, which again, it confuses me. Somehow that's what they turn into. You think if they dehydrate, they just kind of sunken back into flat bodies, kind of sort of the way Cell absorbs his enemies in Dragon Ball Z. But they were spilled, and Batman and Robin have to put the entire bag of dust into a particle separator, or the Bat Particle Separator, or whatever they call it. And obviously they succeed in the end. The acting is different than what I'm used to, that's for sure. It's over the top, but in a good way. Adam West is great at being goofy, may he rest in peace. And Burt Ward is the best live-action Robin, but there's not much competition there. Not that Chris O'Donnell does a bad job, I think he does a great job. In fact, he's probably the better from the performances from Batman Forever and Batman and Robin, but we'll talk about that in a few weeks. But, oh, well, I already said that part. I love the villains. Frank Gorshin is just incredible. They're all so weird and zany. However, now I must make a comment. The effects, man, they are weird. Not only do you get your patented pow, whap, oof. Oof, my favorite word. But you also get these weird, like, it looks like they took a crayon and colored a piece of paper and threw it across the screen. It's the 60s. What are you gonna do? But it appears they do use some well-made sets, and I will give them that. You can see the giant matte paintings that they make. They're totally noticeable, but that's by today's standards, and honestly, I can't say that it bothers me too much. If you've seen the show, then you know how weird these characters can be. You know how weird it can get. That's what this movie does, is it takes all of that and just goes with it. That's so weird. Let me read the back description. When Batman, Adam West, and Robin, Burt Ward, get a tip that Commodore Schmidtlap, Reginald Denny, is in danger aboard his yacht, they launch a rescue mission, but the tip is a setup by the four of the most powerful villains ever, who seek to defeat the dynamic duo once and for all. Armed with a dehydrator that can turn humans into dust, the fearsome foursome, don't say that, intends to take over the world. Can the Caped Crusaders use their high-flying heroism and groovy gadgetry to declaw Catwoman, ice the Penguin, upstage the Joker, and stump the Riddler in time? What? So, obviously, puns galore, bat gadgetry named everything. You know, there's the bat rehydrator, there's the bat computer, bat four, bat something. The only thing that's, and this is weird, now that I think about it, the only thing that doesn't get called the bat whatever is the atomic battery. They don't call it the bat atomic battery or the atomic battery. I don't know, I'm just here for puns, man. I don't really have too much else to say about it. I remember when I got this, I got it from a friend. He was like, hey, you want this? I was like, it's Batman, sure. And I didn't realize, like, I thought for some stupid reason at the age of 7, I thought this was Jack Nicholson and Michael Keaton. I had no idea there was a Adam West Batman. What else is interesting is, so, you know how they do these they used to anyway, scene selection. The entire first 20 minutes, no, not really 20 minutes, it's like 5 minutes, 10 minutes, it's opening credits, and it's just a brick wall with writing on it, and the camera pans over, and you see the actors kind of goofing around. It's like they should have just gone with the intro for the show. I would have loved that. I haven't watched this in a while, and I'm probably going to rewatch it again at some point, just because I love this show. It's one of my favorite Batman shows. So, what am I going to grade this wonderful piece of history here? I'd say a 7 out of 10 is worthy of it. It's really good. There's nothing wrong with it, but, you know, it was the 60s, you know, they were all peace, love, happiness, hippies. So it is what it is. It's what we got, and it's good. I'll give it that. Like I said, got it from a friend. Real thankful. I was like 7, so got like 30 more seconds to get this video over 10 minutes. So next up, I'm gonna record a video for Saw. I already watched it, already reviewed it. Just gotta record the video for it. I'll put it out tomorrow at some point when I have time. Going to my sister's, so when that will be, I can't say. It'll probably be later on in the evening. But if you have time, go check this movie out. It's a very interesting piece of history. So Batman 1966. Give it a watch. All right, next up, we're going to talk about the Saw movie. I'm excited. I got to give it that. See you guys in another video. Hey, I hope you guys enjoyed what you just watched. If you're interested in more of my videos, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon to get notifications every time I upload a video. And also, if you could, just leave a like down below and maybe even consider commenting, telling me things I did good, things I did bad.